from Ben Johnson in Ottawa to Bill Fraley here in Los Angeles. An attempt at 18 feet. His third attempt is unsuccessful.
That was the third miss for Doug Fraley.
Doug Fraley.
At 18 feet, 1.5 minutes.
That young man, two-time 1986 and 87 NCAA indoor champion, now competing for Tom Jennings Pacific Coast Club.
Let's take a look now at how the pole vault all began.
The Sunkist Classics, great moments from this august meet, which has lasted over 25 years here in Los Angeles and has provided inspiration to athletes today. This man has done his share. This is John Pennel as he easily clears 15 feet 6 inches on a new instrument. New to track and field, that is. This is the fiberglass pole replacing the old steel pole. Pennel tackles 16 feet 9 inches. If he is successful, this will be a new world indoor record. With great thrust off the pole, he clears it, officially measured at 16 feet 9.5 inches for the two-time Olympian from Northeast Louisiana. John Pennel, more than 20 years ago, providing guidance to the athletes of today. The progression of the pole vault is interesting. Back in the days of Cornelius Warmerdam, he was the first man over that bar in 1940 at 15 feet. Next came a clearance in 1962 on the fiberglass pole by John Ulsees of 16 feet. It was 1963 when 17 feet was reached by John Pennel, and then followed 18 feet by Chris Papanikolaou in 1970. Then 19 feet was achieved by Thierry Vigneron in 1981.
This was supposed to be a three-way contest between Joe Dial, Mike Tully, and Doug Fraley, with Dial having more indoor experience. But Dwight, that doesn't play tonight, does it?
I have to tell you, all the vaulters seem to be really struggling at this meet. For Joe Dial to be going down to his third attempt at 18 feet, or Doug Fraley to be going down to the third attempt at 18 feet, it's just not like these two athletes. Joe looks to be in very good shape. We'll have to take a look and see this run down the runway. Mike Tully is the only one over this height. Now, he was under on that. He went right under the bar. I'm sure if you had asked Mike Tully before the event if he thought he'd be the only one to jump 18 feet, he would have said there was no way. With this kind of a field, it's a quality field. There are good people in this meet. And now it'll be just a matter of waiting to see what Mike will decide to go to, Phil.
Here you see Dial down the runway. Usually when you go under the bar, you've slowed down on your speed or your last step was too close to the pit. And you abort the jump because you don't get the velocity you need. Look at him, just let go. He told me he wasn't really up in his training this year. He had some personal problems he was working through with his family.
But while they wait, we'll bring you back to Los Angeles.
That's Anthony Curran's third attempt at 18 feet, 1.5 inch. He is gone. Curran, the only lefty out there tonight.
Mike Tully, the winner of the pole vault here at the 1988 Sunkist Invitational. Mike Tully, who has already won the pole vault, is trying now at a height of 18 feet, 6 inches. Did not appear to have any speed at all, Dwight Stones.
Watch him go down the runway, and there again, the plant is fine. He rolls off the par as he should. Watch the rotation. He goes off a bit to the right. The speed down the runway was not enough. He probably needs a stiffer pole at 18 feet, 6.5 inches.
Mike Tully, second attempt at 18 feet, 6.5 inches, jumping alone as he is already the winner of the competition. Much better jump than his first one. He's made the proper adjustments. Now if he can get psychologically into the event at this height, he should have no problem making on his third attempt. A much better attempt, much more aggressive down the runway, in much better position on the pole when he was upside down on the pole.
This is his last attempt, Dwight, at 18, 6.5.
It's going to be very difficult for Mike to motivate himself without any competitors. His second attempt at 18, 6.5 was really outstanding, and he told me a couple of days ago on the phone that he really felt like he was ready physically and mentally for a good indoor season. I think he really was expecting to have some competition from Joe Dial, the American record holder outdoors. He and Joe sort of had a little bit of a feud going on the last couple of years during the outdoor season, but no competition developed tonight amongst what really turned out to be a very good field, but they simply just didn't have what it took to jump well tonight. Here's Mike for his third attempt at 18, 6.5. Tully is such a veteran. He knows how to make adjustments under all conditions. There's no wind indoors, of course. This runway is starting to get a little bit older. It's harder for him to do the things he needs to do on this runway so early in the season. He gets his knees up a little bit better. He's driving well. He's holding high on the pole. He knows he's got to get good bend out of the pole at the bottom. Hold his position, put his legs down a little early, brushed it with the inside of his right arm, but he got the crossbar to stay on, and he gets 18.6.5, which is a very good mark early in the season for Mike Tully. Let's see where his plant was. He's a little under. In fact, he was about 9 inches to a foot under, which is a real good jolt, but Mike's a very strong individual, but he got everything that there was out of that particular vault. He wouldn't have been able to go any higher than that.
Well, Mike Tully, his indoor best, 18.8, set 3 years ago, and he is just an inch and a half shy of that here at the first indoor meet of 1988. Dwight Jones down on the track. Dwight, Mike Tully set for his second and third tries at 19 feet a quarter inch.
Here's Mike on his second attempt, 19 feet quarter inch. Plants under again, just like the first one, but he went ahead with this jump. Got his feet over. And he had reasonably good hip height. Now he's pleased with that. Now that was, gave him enough energy to go on to a third attempt. You have to understand that second place in this event was 17.8.5. He won this event already at 18.6.5. This is his third attempt at 19 feet a quarter inch. Also a bad plant. Hung in there anyway and was really a fine attempt. That's got to make him feel very good that he's jumping at a height 4 inches over his personal best in the first indoor meet without a lot of competition.